Gotta start this channel somewhere, right? Why not today?
So today we're going to be working on something that I've been asked about many times, which is going to be tips for changing fluids on the gear cases that are located underneath a vehicle, and in particular how you're supposed to fill these things back up after draining the old fluid out of them. Today we'll be working on my Nissan Xterra's transfer case, which basically controls the four-wheel drive system if you aren't familiar with what these do. Certain drivetrain components, such as differentials, transfer cases, and in some cases even transmissions, will usually have a drain plug near the bottom, and then a fill plug located higher up that is designed so that you just need to fill it up with whatever fluid it requires until it starts to fall out of the filler hole, as you can see on mine. So it was generally a good idea to remove the filler plug first, because if you drain it and then the filler plug is seized, then you're going to be screwed and won't be able to fill it back up.
Ow!
Seems simple enough, right? But the problem with this is the fill plug is pretty high up and there's always a bunch of crap in the way, which doesn't give you any freaking working room, so filling it up is more of a pain in the ass than playing leapfrog with unicorns. So you're probably asking yourself, hey Marshall, what tips do you have to get this into the top of the transfer case fill port? Well, there's a couple methods that you can use. One of them I've seen online is somebody gets a little squirty thing like this. I mean, this is just for reference. This is a sub dispenser. Nobody actually uses a sub dispenser. You screw that onto the top of the bottle, like so, and you snake a hose from this into the fill hole, and then you sit here like this. But there's actually bubbles coming out, but ignore the bubbles. It's just for demonstration. They sit here like this for like 20 minutes. I don't know about you, but this is going to get real annoying real quick. And plus, your finger's going to be so strong. Well, I mean, you can switch to this. If you're the world-class thumb wrestler, you're actually going to get really strong in this, and then it'll be good at giving people thumbs ups, too. But don't do this. This is stupid. I'll show you the real way.
So what you need to do is get yourself a pressurized fluid filler, which will allow you to cleanly dispense whatever you need into the high and tight places underneath the car. If we come onto my computer and we do a quick Google search, you will see that we have numerous options here for, pressure fluid filler. Oh, you piece of crap. There we go. We'll just jump ahead. What you'll see here is we got numerous options available to us for things to buy. But as you can notice, looking at the screen, they go anywhere from $75 to over $100. If you wanted to use a different fluid with it afterwards, you're going to have to clean it out, wipe it down, flush the lines. Honestly, does anybody really want to do that? Even just looking at this cheapy one on Amazon is still a good 50 bucks. So let me show you a way how to make one of these for peanuts with something you might even have laying around the house.
Yes, a tank sprayer. Used for weed control, watering, fertilizing, and also pest control. You don't need to spend $100-something on the other ones that you gotta clean out every time you change fluids. This thing cost me less than 12 bucks today. And it just takes a very, very minor modification in order to get it to work. So these things, if you're not familiar with them, basically, you fill it with whatever fluid you want to use, you pump it up a whole bunch. This one's kind of hard because I've already done it a bunch. Oh, shit. All right, we'll try that again. You put whatever fluid you want in the bottom of this, you pump this to pressurize it, and then you get a little nozzle right here that is under pressure. And, you can either take this and just lock it in the on position so you don't have to hold it. See? So what you gotta do, this end part right here, you don't need that. Just go ahead and cut it off with a pair of snips. That's all you need to do. Now you got a lot more flow. Hear that? Beautiful. You take that off. You take your transmission fluid or gear oil. Yes, it works with gear oil. Give it a couple pumps. So I'm just gonna show you after you pump it up a little bit and then you push your little trigger right here. Look at that.
So then all you need to do is poke the end into the hole, mind out of the gutter, and then get the flow started by locking the trigger in the on position. I'll even start a timer so we can see how long this will take. And in the meantime, just sit back and listen to some of your favorite tunes or whatever else you like to do for fun. And just like that, it's filled up, spilling out of the bottom of the fill plug and hopefully not making a mess. As you can see, it took roughly 5 minutes and 30 seconds and requires absolutely no effort at all on my behalf in order to get it done. One of the advantages of these is that they are cheap as hell, so if you want to have several of them set up with your favorite fluids on tap to be ready to go whenever, then, well, by all means, you can start a little family of bottles and be ready for battle.
Aww. Well, there you go. Hope it saves you some aggravation, saves you a few bucks, saves you some time, keeps you from making a mess. If you give it a shot and it worked for you, give me a holler in the comments. I'll try to get back to you. Until then, see you in the next one.